Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And now in this episode, we will be winding down season six as we take on Kansas, Oklahoma, and Oklahoma State. You can just see we are 9-0, number two in the country now. As remember, Georgia did lose, opened up that spot for us. And now we are in the driver's seat and we kind of have a clear path to the national championship as long as we keep winning. So looking at our recruiting board, remember I was kind of hands off recruiting this season, but I'm just taking a look at, you know, what the computer's doing. I am adding guys to the board, but letting the computer do the rest pretty much. And they do have a couple of good athletes and a couple of good guys, starting with our number one recruit on the board, Prince, who is the number two defensive end. He's gonna be a monster if we do get him to commit. So let's hop into the action right away. Going up against Kansas on the road, here's Tulevsky starting it out with a big throw across the middle. He's got 35 yards. Jay Taylor. And I think that, you know, going into the draft, we might have to kind of have him as kind of a running back. I don't know if he can change the position. I don't think you actually can, but maybe boost up his receiving ratings a little bit before going into the draft. And we'll see if he does get drafted. Here, continuing this drive, here's a throw across the middle, finding Denzel Knox for 8 yards. Denzel Knox is not having the monster year that he had last year, but he's making his case once again for back-to-back Heismans as he gets to carry on this one up the middle, and he gets in for the 2-yard touchdown run, and we take the 7-0 lead here on the road, and Kansas takes over on the next drive. They do make it to the other side of the 50. Now about the 25. Here's a throw across the middle. And James Thomas at quarterback finds the receiver Harrison. And he can't make the play on that one. Here's another run up the middle on a third down. There's Roderick Jenkins. And Kansas is not having the greatest of years. But they do have actually a decent team. They're about rated in the 90s on offense. And that's actually surprising because they are never good. But they have a good rated team. I'm curious to know why they are struggling to win. Maybe it's the coaching, the offensive scheme. Maybe it's the defense. I'm not sure. But they do have a great rated offense and defense. I mean, their defense is rated in the high 80s. Their offense is rated in the low 90s. I mean, they should be good. But I guess playing in the Big 12, it's a lot of competition. A lot of the same teams as far as ratings go. Nobody's rated too much above anybody else except Texas, who is taking care of business on their side of the conference. So now let's get back to the action. Here on 3rd and 10 on this ensuing drive, here's a throw across the middle. That's Jordan Armstead, who can't hold on to it in traffic. And we had to pump the ball away to Kansas. So now they take back over. And now they make it past the 50 once again. They've been moving the ball pretty well, as that's a nice completion, but not going for anything. Here on 3rd and 7, here's a throw across the middle. And that's going to be a tackle for the first down. Sticks. And Kansas does settle for the second field goal of the game, and that makes it a 7-6 game. As you notice, the defense is a little tougher. You can see that, you know, I've been driving. I'm here in the second quarter. I usually would have a couple of touchdowns by now, on especially a Kansas team who's been struggling. But remember last video, I said I'm turning fatigue off. And I got to tell you, it makes a world of difference because now the computer plays hard the entire game. And you'll see all this defense that they're playing on us. I mean, they're crashing to the ball, even on offense. They're playing good offense. I mean, they're just all around. Look at this. Pressure right up the middle. And that was actually a throw by Ray Reed. Josh Tulevsky was hit a couple times in this game and shaken up. And on that one, he comes out of the game. Here he is back in, inside of 2 minutes, but just taking a beating. Really the Achilles heel, and if we ever lose, it will be because of our pass protection. We have not had good pass protection this season at all as Josh Tulevsky throws to the right side. Sammy Baldwin cannot drag a foot, as that's how it goes in the half, 10-6. So now we come back out in the second half. Here is Knox trying to get going on the ground, picking up a block from Tulevsky that time and getting 9 yards on that one. So now on a 2nd and 1, here's a handoff from the pistol formation right up the middle. That's Knox, but he gets shaken up. And Kansas has been hitting hard in this game, and maybe that's a thing that we have to do. We have to keep fatigue off, because now I'm seeing more injuries, which is realistic. But here's a throw across the middle. Here's Ross. He gets the interception, and Tulevski makes his first mistake of the game, probably underthrowing that one a little bit, and maybe it was just a better play by J.J. Ross. So our defense has been balling out in this game. Here's a deep shot on the towards the right side, and that's going to be caught by Raheem Okusi. Look at him going up in traffic there and just snagging the ball, and the senior makes the play, and that sets us up on the other side of the 50. Our defense has been making stops, giving us good field position back in this drive, and here's Denzel Knox, 9 yards up the middle, and he's got 48 yards, a quiet 48 on 12 carries. Here's a throw across the middle. There's Okusi getting going, 10 yards and a touchdown. And he gets in for the first touchdown of the game through the air. And that's going to be a 17-6 lead, as Tulevski's actually 9-for-22 up to this point. You can just see the defense and how well they are playing for Kansas. Here's a carry up the middle. And Jenkins, we thought we had the stop in the backfield, and he gets upfield for a nice gain of 6. So now a 2nd and 4. Here's a carry up the middle, but look at the hit by Marcus Daniels. Lays the boom on Jenkins, and wow. Jenkins is actually bigger than him, and he just lays him out on that one. So now 3rd and 5. Here's Thomas, a throw to the left side, and he's got Harrison beating Josh Hemphill on the outside, and that's a nice catch and a nice throw. Nice touch on that one. That makes it a 1st and 10. He's going to throw out to the right. It is picked off by Andrew Jordan, the All-American. And wow, look at this. We are just playing some good defense here in a close game, as we are actually on a little bit of an upset alert, because Kansas is playing really well so far in the first three quarters. So here is Jordan Armstead getting going. He's got a nice gain of about 17 on that one. So now a 2nd and 6, throw out to the right side. There's a nice throw to Raheem Okusi, who's having a big game. That's a gain of 20 as a senior, showing his leadership on that receiving core. So here on a 1st and 10, here's a screen pass out to the left side. Here is Jay Taylor lined up at running back once again. He's got a gain of 6. So now a 2nd and 4, handoff, dual backs in the backfield. Look at Knox fighting forward, and he's picking up a 1st down on a 7-yard carry on that one. So now we get into a 3rd and 4. Ray Reed into the game now. Tulevski's getting shaken up in this one. He comes out for one play, and Ray Reed facing some pressure. He's not exactly the most elusive guy, but he makes the throw over the middle, and we settle for the field goal. So now it's a 20-6 game. Moving on to the 4th quarter. Here's another carry up the middle for Knox. And with that carry, Denzel Knox is the all-time leading rusher in SJSU history. Congrats to him. And you know what? He could be back for one more year after this season. So now here's Tulevski on a 1st and 10, throwing the ball deep. Over to the right side, Champagne Green walks in. Nice block downfield. And that's a touchdown. And his 2nd touchdown pass of the game. He's recovered pretty nicely, Tulevski has, as he's 14-for-31. And that one is going to go on to seal this game here, as this was a nice win on the road versus a tough Kansas team. And like I said, their record won't show that they're a tough team, but they definitely have the players on offense and defense, and maybe even that fatigue being off definitely made a difference, because, I mean, honestly, that was a tough game. Getting yards on offense and even playing defense, it was the game was actually way closer than the score. It ended up being 34-13. Denzel Knox actually had an 80-yard run in this game, and I didn't actually sim that one. I've been trying to get through these games as well, so I simmed that one, but he ended up getting 170-something yards on the ground. What a big game from him. Jordan Mann has 2 sacks in this game, the true freshman, and then Andrew Jordan gets the interception in the win. So we do end up moving on to the next game. We have 2 games left, and we end up beating Oklahoma. And you can see right here, we are ranked number 1 in the nation. Notre Dame does lose to Miami, and that was their 1st loss of the season. So we are the only undefeated team left in the NCAA. But if you look at this game playing Oklahoma, I mean, this was an all-around game, as we actually had a little bit of news going into next week, because you noticed that Ray Reed and Tulevski were both in this game. Tulevski's hurt. A broken femur, out for the season. So that means we are going to have to lean on the senior who was in a quarterback battle going into this season anyway. And let's just look at the season that Tulevski has. His season is done. 17 touchdowns and 16 interceptions. And he didn't exactly have the spark that I thought he would have. But he did his job. He was winning games, so I didn't make a change. But now I'm going to have to. Ray Reed, he comes in 99 awareness, 83 throw power, 86 accuracy. Let's see what he'll do. So we send the next game, Oklahoma State. They were 5-6 on the year, and we complete the perfect regular season, 12-0, winning 35-28. This was a shootout, but look at the game that Ray Reed had. 4 touchdowns, no picks. That's an amazing game in his first start. Akusi goes 13 receptions for 138 yards and a touchdown, and even Jordan Armstead gets 3 touchdown catches in this game. A great win to cap off an undefeated season. So, you know, here's what it looks like here as we did simulate that last game. Alabama's 9-1, NC State's 9-1, and Georgia is 9-1, and so is Notre Dame. They're 10-1. So Notre Dame, remember I mentioned that they did lose to Miami, but then, you know, just looking at the rest of the standings here, there's a lot of teams that can end up here in the national championship depending on how conference championship week goes. So we'll have to see how the season will wind up. So let's just look at our end of season stats here as Ray Reed, with that 4 touchdown game, improves to 6 touchdowns and 1 interception, and he's going to have to step up big time. He is a senior, so I'm not really that worried, and I think that we can lean on him quite heavily. Knox has 22 touchdowns on the year. Raheem Akusi does end up leading our team in reception, so he comes back there on Sammy Baldwin, who started out pretty fast. Champagne Green took over towards the middle of the season, and then now Raheem Akusi comes back and has 2 big games towards the end of the season as well. So looking at our defense, Michael Cummings does lead our team in tackles. No surprise there. But Zamir Hines ends up being second. I'm actually surprised by that. Monaga I thought would be second on our team, but ends up being Zamir Hines. I'm pretty proud of that as the JUCO transfer does end up having a pretty good season. Luther Bridges leads our team in sacks. I didn't expect that. I definitely thought that James Jackson Jr. would have double-digit sacks, but I mean, it's tough to replace guys like Terrence Miller and Andre Armstead. We were spoiled. Looking at our interception leaders, Andrew Jordan leads with 4. Monaga had 3. He finally can hold on to the ball. JoJo Forrest had 2 from the slot, from that nickel position. And then Zamir Hines also had 2. So that's going to do it here in this episode. You know, like I said, just looking at the conference standings really quick and just looking at the Heisman, Denzel Knox is actually second here in the Heisman race. And, you know, it's kind of surprising a little bit because James Washington, he has had a good year, but Michigan hasn't had the team success. And I would think that, you know, going into the Heisman, a team success does have a little bit more to do with it. Even though James Washington, he has 1,500 yards rushing, 22 touchdowns. Denzel Knox is having a lesser of a year, 1,300 yards, 22 touchdowns. But we're on the number one team in the nation. I thought that would weigh a little bit more. But I guess it kind of has to be a little bit of a rotating trophy. So I guess that's how it goes. So looking at the Big 12, our side of the division didn't have a great year, but it can go either way because our regular season is done, but other teams do still have 2 games left. Texas is leading their side of the division, and my guess is that they will actually pull it out with 2 games left versus West Virginia and Texas Tech, who are both 5-5. I'm pretty sure they're going to win those 2 games. We'll have to see how that goes, but I'm preparing to play Texas right now. I think that they're going to finish it out and close out their season with 2 wins. TCU is right behind them in conference, but they're 5-4. I don't really see much promise in them. But then looking at our side, Oklahoma finishes with 3 conference losses. I thought they were going to be a little bit better, and I wanted a little bit of a challenge going into the Big 12, and that's how it is. So that's going to do it for this episode. We're going into conference championship next week, so hit subscribe, hit that like button. We'll see who we play. Stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.